This schematic on Teknic's website shows a ClearPath system with its accessories, required and optional. Each accessory has a small question mark by it. When you click, it shows useful information. This is helpful, but if you want even more detail, keep watching. We're going to discuss each accessory one by one. First, you need an SC network communication hub. Among other functions, this hub converts USB or high-speed RS-232 from your host CPU into optically isolated signaling. This allows for well over 1,000 commands per second with excellent noise immunity. You can connect any mix of up to 4 AC-powered integral horsepower ClearPath motors or DC-powered fractional horsepower motors per hub. And you can daisy-chain up to 4 hubs per COM port, so your system can have 16 motors for every USB or RS-232 port you have available. So, for example, on a host with 3 COM ports, you could have up to 48 axes of motion. The hubs can be conveniently daisy-chained by plugging them directly together or distributed where you want them by using DB9 male-to-female cables available from Amazon for about $8. To power the communication hub, you need to supply 24 volts DC. This 10-foot cable has a 2-pin Molex MiniFit Junior connector on both ends, so it can be used to daisy-chain 24-volt power between 2 SC hubs, or you can re-terminate one end as needed by your 24-volt power supply. The complete SC communication hub design package is available from Teknic as free open-source information in case a 4-axis hub is not ideal for you, or if you want to incorporate the SC hub functionality into your own board. All the software you need to set up your ClearPath SC motors and develop your application is available for free with an unlimited right to copy on Teknic's download page. The ClearView installer includes Windows setup software with diagnostic tools, the ClearPath S Foundation C++ class library, including a .NET interface, and thorough documentation with lots of example code. The ClearView setup program runs on Windows. The class library is available for Windows or Linux. The download contains the entire S Foundation source code package with an OEM-friendly open source license for free. Next, you need a few cables. You need a controller cable to connect ClearPath to the SC communications hub, and a USB cable to connect your host computer to the SC hub. You'll also need an AC power cable. Let's start with the controller cable. It connects ClearPath to the SC communications hub. Teknic offers 2 controller cable options to choose from. The first is a 10-foot cable. It has 8-pin Molex MiniFit Junior connectors on both ends. The connector for the motor end is overmolded. The other end has a connector with no overmolding. But you can use this end inside the motor if you prefer. It takes up a little less room, and if you use the appropriate cable glands, the junction box will be fully sealed anyway. The connector will not fit through a cable gland, so you'll have to extract the pins from the connector, push the cable through, and reinsert the pins. The 55-foot cable has overmolded connectors on both ends. Because neither end can fit through a cable gland, you'll have to cut off and then replace one connector to use this cable. This is only recommended if you have the proper tools and components to rebuild the cut end. If you want to do this, or make your own cables, you'll find all the required connector part numbers in the ClearPath user manual, as well as the part numbers for the necessary tools. Don't try to make these cables without the proper tools. You'll almost certainly end up with flaky connections and frustration. The next cable is the USB communications cable. This cable connects your host computer to the SC hub. It's a 10-foot standard USB A to B cable. You probably have one of these cables lying around somewhere, but this cable is nice because it's 10 feet long, which is convenient when you can't easily get the PC close to your machine. It's also a high-quality cable that won't have noise or connector issues. The final required cable is the AC power cable. Generally, all you need here is raw cable stock. The motor end of the cable goes into a screw terminal block, so there's no connector on the motor end. The other end usually is wired into the screw terminals of a circuit breaker. Depending on your AC power source, you may need 3, 4, or 5 wire cable stock. You can purchase appropriate AC power cable stock from many online sources. The wire needs to be 12 or 14 gauge. Stranded wire is easier to work with and more flexible than solid copper. To summarize, you will need one SC communication hub for every 4 motors in your system, a user-supplied 24-volt power supply providing at least 300 milliamps per hub, and a 24-volt cable per hub, a controller cable to connect your ClearPath motor to the SC communication hub, a USB A to B cable to connect your host computer to the SC hub, an AC power cable, and finally, a free download of the ClearView and S Foundation installation package. The first optional accessory is a cable to route user-supplied 24-volt logic backup power into the motor. If AC line power to the motor is interrupted, let's say because your application cuts motor power upon an emergency stop, the 24-volt power will keep the motor awake so it can continue to keep track of its commanded and actual position. The same cable part number used for 24-volt power can also be used for brake control and global stop functions. The first SC hub on the USB or serial port can accept a global stop command to stop all motors with one digital signal. It can also automatically control 1 or 2 24-volt brakes, which are sometimes used to hold vertical axes during power-off conditions. Optionally, you can pass digital signals through the SC hub to ClearPath's optically isolated inputs to trigger a position capture, limit torque, or stop motion, for example. For each signal, you'll want to get a digital I/O cable to connect between the SC hub and your signal. 24-volt DC and ground are supplied on this cable by the SC hub for convenient wiring of 24-volt sensors. In case you're wondering how much 24-volt power you'll need to supply, there's a table in the SC user manual you can fill out to calculate the total 24-volt power requirement for your complete system, motors, communication hubs, power hubs, brakes, etc. The other optional accessory is a USB A to B cable. With it, you can run your program on the host computer through the SC hub application data channel and use the ClearView application at the same time to monitor a motor through the independent diagnostic data channel. This allows you to collect valuable data about a motor and its mechanics, torque usage, accuracy, etc., while running and without disturbing the normal operation of your application code. Normally, energy is directed from the motor drive into the motor, such as when accelerating a load. But decelerating a large or gravitational load can cause energy to be pumped back into a motor's drive electronics. If this regenerated energy is high enough, the motor drive will get an overvoltage shutdown. ClearPath integral horsepower motors use a proprietary algorithm to absorb this energy more so than other motors, and the RES-225 regenerated energy shunt accessory can handle even more. The RES-225 can handle 7 kilowatts of regenerated power for brief periods, and 250 watts on average, allowing controlled and emergency decelerations of inertial and gravitational loads without overvoltage shutdowns. Using 2-conductor, 12 to 14 gauge wire, you connect the positive and negative terminals from the RES-225 to the positive and negative terminals of your ClearPath motor. That's all you have to do. The RES-225 is fully automatic and there are no settings to adjust. Any motor with a 3, 4, or 5 before the P in its part number will gain more than 50% more continuous torque by adding the blower option. To use the blower, you need single-phase 208 volts AC, 3-conductor 12 or 14 gauge cable stock, and a cord grip for a 1/2-inch trade size opening. In addition to standard face mounting, ClearPath integral horsepower motors can be foot mounted using the cast aluminum rigid base foot mount accessory. The foot can be attached to any of the 3 sides not occupied by the junction box. Be sure to note that the shaft center is 4.25 inches from the mounting surface of the foot. This is 3/4 of an inch more than the standard for NEMA 56 and NEMA 143 motors, and roughly 0.25 inches more than the standard for IEC 100 frame size motors. Finally, there's a component you might want to add, but probably shouldn't: a shaft key. Many mechanisms are coupled to induction motor shafts with the combination of a shaft key and a set screw. This sort of fastening is marginally okay for single-direction, constant-velocity applications, but with ClearPath's ability to start, stop, and reverse with high power and precision, you'll want something better. After years of seeing every fastening method under the sun, we've found that modern specialty adhesives, for example, Loctite retaining adhesive for cylindrical components, are an excellent solution. Used properly, it holds extremely well, but components can still be easily removed with a heat gun. Clamp-style couplings and keyless bushings are also excellent choices. Contact Teknic for further information, and if you still want to use a key as backup, see the user manual for proper dimensions and tolerances.